There we go. So, I almost did not come on just now because I'm feeling vulnerable and raw. But I really want to share what I'm feeling. Went to visit my grandmother and surprised her. She was literally speechless and started crying. And there were just so many sweet moments while I was there. And she gifted us with a bunch. She just loves, she collects stuff for us all the time. And she has some really old, cool stuff, like vintage, cool things. And there was a moment where I was hungry, and she's very simple. Usually I don't eat a lot of the same foods. She doesn't have as clean of a diet as me. But she's like, I can make you a ham and cheese sandwich. And I could hear the excitement in her voice, like how excited she'd be to make her granddaughter a ham and cheese sandwich. And so I was like, yeah. And she was just, she was so delighted to have me there and make me a sandwich. And then there's another side of it. Her boyfriend, who she's had since I was in the womb, since my mom was a teenager, is not really a well person. And basically, I was abused by him, and I witnessed him abuse my Nana and my mom. And so, you know, if I have to be in his energy field or in their home, I have to be really prepared to navigate all the different energies and emotions that may come up. And this visit was really great. Nothing came up, and you know, I noticed like certain feelings and memories, but no like big anxiety, and felt like an amazing trip. It felt so good to show up for her, and I could see how happy it made her, and even him, and seeing him happy as much as I've seen him hurt others, including myself. My heart, you know, my heart doesn't want people to hurt. I don't want people to hurt, and then nobody's hurting. When I got home, I experienced this giant high. Like, I literally felt like I was high. And I was all excited, and I was going to do all the stuff that she gave us, and talked with my mom about how sweet it was, and her crying and her speechlessness, and making me the ham and cheese sandwich, and then I started just going off on her boyfriend. I had found out he had done something that was inappropriate while I was there, but I'm blind, I didn't see it. So that just set me off. And then I experienced anxiety last time. I was like sweating and shaking, and I wasn't feeling high and happy anymore. I had to sit down and just breathe and ground and remind myself this is where I am. None of that's happening anymore. That was in the past. Things are well. Think about how good that experience was, like how much it served the greater good, and how nice it was to see my Nana personally and see her light up and contribute to her well-being. And I always have like a come down after seeing certain people or going in certain containers like this, that I have a lot of trauma that I'm sitting in a room with one of my abusers, and I just, it's interesting to sit and just like remember, like, oh, we're here for Nana, and everything's good and happy and well and nothing's going, you know, there's no abuse happening anymore. That's the past, and be in the present. It's fucking hard. And so I had a big come down experience. And so I have these awesome, like, hand exercise or stress ball things that my nana gave me. And one of these my nana didn't give me. In Love Coach Academy, we talk about how we respond and react out of different parts emotionally. One of them is the head. And my nana gave me this brain. So sometimes we respond out of our head, which is not really one of the things that was happening. Like, I had to really use my brain today, though. And then sometimes we respond in the heart, which is a space I really dropped into today. And a space I love to always live in. And not react to live from. And then we respond sometimes from our heart. And this is a heart with a band-aid on it. I'm going to give you all these little things, so I put a band-aid on this one. And this is the place of which I could have went into today. And I gave myself some empathetic, loving space when I got home to be in my hurt, but not share that and create external experiences for others through reacting to my hurt. And I'm also deeply aware this man, my abuser, my nana's boyfriend that I had to sit with today, did what he did, does what he does, out of his hurt, very, very hurt. He can't be, he's not a happy person. He's hurting. So, and then, this is one that my nana did not give me. My ex-girlfriend gave this to me. This is my stress cock. And I talked about the other day. Love Coach Academy doesn't talk about this. I brought it up. Some people react and respond from hurt that's directly related to our sex center. Or we respond and react and act out of here. And this is one of the areas that this man blended these two things, his hurt and his sexual energy, and he hurt others, including myself with his hurt, and using sexual energy in a harmful way. And that's a thing that people do sometimes. And I believe in sexual energy for healing and conscious use of sexual energy. But y'all know what I'm talking about. And so I know it's really intense, and I'm navigating it. I'm feeling really good. I did a lot of processing when I got home, and it feels really good to drop into this empathetic space and think of him this way, and think of myself and the ways in which I could have gone, it could have gone, and empathetic understanding for what it was and why this person, this man, chose to do what he did. And does. And then this little guy, it says, live healthy and has a heart. And eventually I'm going to come up with a name and a character for him and what he represents. It says, live healthy and it has a heart. It seems kind of obvious, you know? But I want to give it a real, theme and character and name and emotional experience. And then I have a phone. And, you know, obviously this would probably refer to connection and reaching out and sourcing. Maybe this would be like self-sourcing, and this would be external sourcing. Great tools for navigating emotions, your heart, your hurt, and all that fun stuff. So that's that. I'm gonna go. I needed to just drop in and talk about that, but it was pretty intense, and I'm thirsty. I'm feeling dehydrated. I've been not drinking enough water. So my body is like tight navigating this, and you know, like I said, for me it's like after going into these places, sometimes it's like I have like come down. It takes me a little bit to come back and ground because of how much trauma is centered around this person. So we'll see. I'm feeling really good about it though. Like on the whole, like I see the healing